When we say bugs, most people think of something like this. But developers know it means there are hours of work ahead of them. Hi, and welcome to another episode about work visualization. Today, we'll show you how to understand bugs better and monitor them using visualization. Ready to find out more? Creating fully functional software doesn't exclude slip-ups from happening. When an unexpected software behavior occurs, finding a way to fix it is necessary. To do so, you need to visualize bugs, track them, and keep them in sight. Start with creating a detailed, top-notch bug report. It'll be the star of the show. A bug report should contain all the useful info on the bug. Once you create a perfect bug report, use it as a template, or write a bug template to create an ideal bug report. Either way can work. Top tip, if you're using a board to visualize your work, prepare ready-made bug reports with the following categories that a team member can fill in when reporting a bug. Here's what a perfect bug report should have. It should contain a bug ID that you can use to reference it if need be, and bug title for easier understanding. Bug number 334 does not sound as catchy as the "when logging in, the interface is green" bug. It should also have the info on the bug reporter in case more information is needed. The team will know who to contact for details. Make sure to include the date and time to know precisely when this bug occurred. It might help to find the root of the problem by linking it to an event that took place at that specific time. Knowing which platform was used when the bug occurred is extremely important, as it can make all the difference. One of the most critical parts of a bug report are the steps of reproduction. Include them to give everyone a chance to try it out for themselves. Make sure visual media is also included. Remember that a picture is worth a thousand words. The bug report should also contain info on priority and severity. Don't forget to include the technical context, which can be of great importance for the team. And of course, conversational how the bug was reported. Including the activity log will help monitor what's going on with the bug, who's working on it, or helping to find the solution. The bug description is one of the most critical parts of the bug report. Being as detailed as possible when writing a bug description will help the devs come to the bottom of it. Don't make it difficult to understand and read. Go step by step when describing a bug. Sometimes formatting the text is half of the job well done. Use formatting, bullet points, and lists to make it easy to read, follow, understand, and reproduce by including all the vital info. Once you are 100% sure you have a bug issue, enriched with a detailed description of the problem, assess its priority. Not all bugs bear the same significance. Is the bug affecting many users, making it impossible for them to use the software? Or is it just a mild inconvenience that affects only some users? The difference is massive. A bug can also be anywhere in between those two extremes of the priority scale. Be as it may, it should be fixed, but it might not be the team's priority. Another thing to consider is whether there are any more important issues to be resolved first. Ask yourself, is this bug, however significant or insignificant, a blocker that will prevent other changes from happening? Now that you have all the info on the bug and processes that are going on simultaneously, where do you put it? The easiest way to track bugs is to use a board for visualization and place the bug on a board. We've covered some board visualization ideas in our previous videos, so check them out. You can place a bug in a separate column if you use a Kanban method, on a board or on a timeline, depending on your strategy. Make sure the bug is easily spotted, especially if it's a high priority issue, or you could also make a separate board and notification just for bugs. If you're using a digital tool, such as Active Collab, for tracking your work and progress, you can perhaps create a separate project for bugs only, or put a label on this task and use high priority to highlight the bug. Once the bug is on the board, it is crucial to maintain sight of it and follow it through its life cycle from the moment it was first noticed and documented. Create a label or think of a way to show the stage the bug is in visually. Was it just spotted or tested, or was the solution already implemented? Sometimes the bugs reappear and it's essential to note down all the crucial info so that you can refer back to it. And see how you can use what you have learned from this bug situation to make the most of it and learn from experience to prevent the future issues from occurring. Once the bug is fixed, it's still not the end of its life cycle, as you should probably let the client's team or stakeholders know about it being fixed. We have already mentioned some types of bugs, such as recurring bugs. Those are the bugs that happen again after some time and are presumably easier to solve. However, you still need to find a way for them not to re-emerge in the future. And, of course, blocker bugs that prevent you from moving on to another issue. A blocker bug must be dealt with before the devs can continue working on other tasks. Some teams distinguish between who reported the bug and whether it was reported by users or testers, which is helpful info to have, especially when reporting back to whoever wrote the bug in the first place. Bugs prioritization depends on it. Let's say an important client finds an annoying bug and lets you know about it almost every day. It will require a different course of action than when a developer finds a bug that is slightly annoying, but doesn't affect anyone's work and no one has complained about it. It's essential to be able to visually distinguish different types of bugs, which you can do by using labels, magnets, or sticky notes in different colors. That's it for this video, guys. I hope you've enjoyed it. Let us know what the next video should be about in the comments and stay tuned. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. See you soon. Tracking your work in progress, especially when reporting back to whoever. Remember to like, share, and subscribe to our channel. See you soon.